This tutorial is part of our practical database design course. You can find a link to the YouTube playlist for this course in the video description. Alternatively, if you like this course, you can watch the complete course uninterrupted, ad-free, access updated tutorials and download the source code and more from our Udemy course. Again, the link to the course is in the video description. So far, we have introduced the relational database management system, the concept of a database and a table or an entity. There is another layer here, and that's within the table. So strictly speaking, within the table, there needs to be a better way of organizing data rather than just putting it in this square. So here inside of our table, we have fields. In this tutorial, we move a step deeper into the table and discuss the role of a field. In addition to that, we also discuss the relationship between the attribute and the field. However, if you watched the previous tutorial, you may have already guessed the answer to why we might have two ways to express what will end up being described as the field. I will summarize here because we have already briefly introduced the idea or concept of logical and physical design stages in the previous tutorial. While at the logical stages of our design, we refer to the field as an attribute. Once it is implemented in our relational database management system, we might then refer to this as a field. We can think of them as referring to the same concept, much like an entity and table. More importantly, what is a field and where does it fit into our diagram? Generally speaking, our table is divided up into fields or columns and rows. So we can visualize our table in this tabular format consisting of columns, so our fields, and then the rows, so the rows spanning across. So therefore, a database field, as you can see here, data is stored in this field, is the smallest unit of storage in our database. As you can see from this diagram, each column will be given a name. So we have some column names. And the idea then is to insert rows into our database, referring to each column and inserting the correct data in each column. Therefore, each field, in this case, the student ID field here, will store values related to the context of the field. So here it's the student ID. So here we have a number representing the student ID and so on. So we have student name here, this column, and you can see that this field is storing the name of the student. What is important to visualize here is how data is inserted into the database table. So this is our database table. We have some columns or fields and rows. Now, typically, if we are going to insert new data into our table, it's inserted as a whole row. And notice this row is made up of columns or fields. And for each field, we insert the value which is represented by the column name. So the student ID gets inserted, and then the subject ID, the subject fee, and then the student name. So this makes up one record, one row, one entry into our table. Looking at our table here, we can start to identify why we might use the terminology attributes for fields. If you remember, we stated that at the start of the design process, we think of tables as entities. So the entity here being student. So the student is something we want to model, store information about. Now, this entity has attributes. So what are the attributes of the student? These attributes are what we're going to store or record information about. And this then makes up our field names or our attribute names. So here we have an entity, a student, and we then consider what attributes do we need to store information about that attribute, that entity, sorry. So in this case, we have student ID, name, age, and address. So that's all related. These are all attributes of our student. So by using the terminology entity for a table, attributes for fields, it helps us focus in on what it is that we're trying to achieve at the start of a design process to help us identify something we want to model, our entities, and what attributes might be associated to that entity, to that object, that thing that we're trying to record information about in our database. So to summarize, we can think or start to use the terminology attributes at the logical design stage, which will then be referenced as fields once implemented within our relational database management system. Although saying that, sometimes it can be better to describe a field a field, so I will try and use the terminology appropriately throughout this course. So we have also learned that although we can loosely describe that the database or table can store data, it is at the field level, the database table field, that is the smallest unit of storage in our database. I would like to plant another seed here and mention the importance of fields, which is sometimes overlooked when designing a database. Without appropriately defining a field, the field could not be implemented in a database. Although only a unit of storage, the field has a major role in our endeavor to uphold data integrity throughout our database. Thus, we should ensure that we have always fully considered and defined the properties and attributes of our field. Okay, so that sounds a bit cryptic here at this stage, but hopefully this will unfold throughout the course.